Hey, Michael Rosenblum here. I want to talk to you about the media, and you may think that sitting in my English garden is a funny place to do that, but actually it's the best place to do it because I want to make a really important point about the potential for a completely different kind of world of media. I'm here in the garden, and I grew up in Manhattan, so I don't know any of this stuff, and we grow our own fruits and vegetables. This is a strawberry that we grow. And let me tell you, when you take a strawberry, God, that's good. When you take a strawberry, you actually grow yourself and you eat it. It's a million times better than the stuff you buy in the store. That's because the stuff in the store is done by giant industrial conglomerates that are only interested in selling you stuff. It doesn't have to taste good, and it doesn't taste good. Once you start to grow your own food, you understand what food is supposed to taste like. Now, 100 years ago or so, almost all of us grew our own food. We were all, 80% of the population of the United States was farming. People who are farmers and grow their own food would never eat Doritos or Pringles. People with dairy cows would never eat Cool Whip. They understand that that's a pile of chemicals. But we've gotten so distanced from food. Did you know that six major corporations control almost all the food? 10 major corporations control almost all our food. And what are those companies? Mars, PepsiCo, Coca-Cola, Nestle, and what do they make? Mars bars, M&Ms, Coca-Cola, Cherry Coke, Diet Coke. I mean, it's no wonder the country is obese. The reason it's obese is because those companies make stuff for the purpose of selling it. They're not really interested in your nutrition or your food. There goes my farmer neighbor taking his horses up. The media is exactly the same thing. The media in this country is controlled by six major corporations. Six major corporations control 95% of what you see. And their interest is not nutrition, intellectual nutrition, any more than Nestle's interest is in food nutrition. Their interest is in selling you stuff also. Most of us never made our own media, so we can't tell the difference. When you grow your own strawberries, you immediately know that the stuff in the supermarket is terrible. Well, now for the first time, because of this, this is an iPhone. This is kind of like strawberries, homegrown strawberries, but for media. You can grow your own media, and that's the reason I want to talk to you about what I would call organic media. The media world, all the stuff you see on the news, all the stuff you see in entertainment, is done by giant corporations like Nestle and Coca-Cola and PepsiCo make Pringles and stuff like that. These media companies also make junk, essentially, to feed you and to force down your throat. And Pringles and Doritos and Coca-Cola make the country obese. We all know that's a big problem. Well, the kind of crap that the media companies make us have fat heads instead of fat stomachs, but it's exactly the same thing. It's fundamentally unhealthy. Here comes the farmer again. So what I'm saying is that you can grow your own media using this, and I'm going to teach you how to do that if you're really interested. I think the time is ripe for what we would call organic media, that is homegrown media. Instead of you depending on news or CBS or Fox or whoever it is to tell you what's going on in the world, and they're not really telling you what's going on in the world, they're showing you stuff that they think will get your eyeballs so that you'll stay with them. And Facebook and Instagram, Twitter, they're all no different. They're only interested in seducing you with salty, sweet, fat stuff. Instead of being, you know, the obvious Mars bars and M&Ms to get you addicted on that, they give you scary stories, terrorists, people on the border, stuff like that, Twitter, all that kind of stuff. It's not really true. I mean, fake news, it is fake news in a way, because it's designed specifically to get you addicted, just like Pringles are designed to get you addicted, and just like Pringles make you fat, those kind of Twitter things and that bad news also make you fat in the head. So what I'm saying is that we can raise, like we grow our own food here, you can grow your own media. And I am happy to teach you how to do that. We've been teaching a lot of people how to do that. It's an idea I had, but it's just getting started. But I think this notion of organic media is something that's really interesting and has a lot of potential to change the world. I mean, you're not going to give up your addiction to media, but you're not going to give up your eating either. But you can eat vegan, and you can eat healthy, and you can eat farm to table, and you can eat organic food, and you'll feel better and you'll be healthy. And now we can also have you can consume organic media. And if you're interested in that, stick with me, because I'm going to tell you how to do it.